Welcome to week two of the ISU Junior Grand Prix 2018. I'm your host, Ted Barton, and this week we're in the charming city of Linz. Linz is the third largest city in Austria. It is located in the northern center of Austria, approximately 30 kilometers south of the Czech border, and is constructed on both sides of the famous river Danube. The population of the city is just over 200,000. Linz is a lively, modern city which has a long and eventful history, and the architecture of its developed city center with the Baroque hot plots is unique, but it merges seamlessly with a beautifully urban lifestyle and exciting cultural scene. Week one in Bratislava produced some remarkable skating in all disciplines. In men, 13-year-old Stephen Gogolev of Canada, in his first Junior Grand Prix event, delivered it all. In ladies, Anna Shcherbakova of Russia, delightful and dominant. In pairs, Anastasia Mishina and Alexander Gelyamov of Russia, brilliant. And in dance, Elizaveta Kudaberdieva and Nikita Nazarov were simply superb and charming. We have four of last year's Junior Grand Prix finalists here this week in Linz. In men, Kamden Polkinen of the United States. In ladies, Alina Korsanaya of Russia. In dance, Marjorie Lajoie and Zachary Laga of Canada. And in pairs, Anastasia Polyanova and Dmitry Sopot of Russia round out perhaps some of the returning favorites from last season. This is week two in Linz. Stories begin to unfold, and it starts right now. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the charming city of Linz to look at the Danube River with the beautiful Viking cruise ships parked alongside. Lots of tourists come through this part of the world every summer. And a look at the arena hosting the Junior Grand Prix 2 years ago, or 3 years ago, we were here to cover another Junior Grand Prix event. We're back. We love coming here to Linz, Austria. Welcome inside the building. You're watching live coverage of the ISU Junior Grand Prix 2018. I'm your host, Ted Barton. We welcome viewers from around the world who have joined in to watch some extraordinary young people passionately deliver a sport of beauty. Levels of skill covers the extreme ends of the spectrum, from traditionally strong skating nations and those discovering and developing arenas and programs. We welcome you all. Thank you for joining coverage of the ISU Junior Grand Prix. Now make sure that you follow us on social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and of course YouTube. We hope you all subscribe to the Junior Grand Prix YouTube channel, where you will be first to know when a video or a live stream is available. If you love the Junior Grand Prix, you don't want to miss out on a thing, make sure you subscribe to the Junior Grand Prix YouTube channel.
The following competitors may now take the ice for a 5-minute warm-up.
If you're watching on a computer or mobile device, just click on the little ISU logo at the bottom right-hand portion of the screen to subscribe.
From Austria, first event up today, Patrick Kuba.
The rhythm dance. First group of skaters on the ice for their warm-up. And here's a look at the technical panel for this event.
And from Russia, Sofia Savchenko and Igor Eremenko.
And now the judges.
Answer.
And here's a look at the start order for the event.
Skaters, there's 1 minute remaining in your warm-up.
Just a reminder that some of the rules have changed in the delivery of the scores. There's a range of +5 to -5 now, as opposed to +3 to -3, giving the judges much more to work with and separating the detail and the qualities of each one of the technical elements in all the disciplines. Won't go into a lot of detail there, but we'll talk about that during this event. Ice Rhythm Dance takes the ice right now, 1400 hours here in Linz, and the men's short program goes tonight or later this afternoon at 16:30, so stay tuned for that. That should be an exciting event. Remember to follow us on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and Twitter. Send your questions, your comments. Love to share them.
Our first couple on the ice today, from Israel, Alice Rogatnik and Ihor Barzak.
Alice and Ihor are both 15 years old. They're coached and choreographed by Maria Cheka. This is their first Junior Grand Prix season. skating their rhythm dance this afternoon to flamenco and tango.
Alice Rogatnik and Ihor Barzak.
Some of the elements for Alice and Yehor. There's the twizzle started a little too far apart, out of synchronization. Level three on that first side, level four in the second, with a minus GOE just under one. And remember, there's a 5-point scale for the plus and a 5-point scale for the minus, so it gives you a little bit of an idea of the qualities that are being awarded in the technical elements. Here's a look at the compulsory portion of the dance. There are, of course, key points the judges are specifically looking towards, and they either get a yes or a no if they accomplish that particular edge or step.
Please.
They train in Kiev for the entire season, about 27 hours a week. Again, this is her first Junior Grand Prix.
And
the scores for Alison Yehor, 38.05. They're the first team out in this competition.
They're currently in the first place. On the ice, representing Austria, Corinna Huber and Patrick Huber.
Corinna and Patrick, 15 years old, both born in Pécs, Hungary. This is their first Junior Grand Prix season. They're coached and choreographed by Dimitri Sildoya. Let's get into a tango, paso doble, and a tango.
Corinna Huber and Patrick Huber.
Well, very first time out for Corinna and Patrick on the Junior Grand Prix. You can see lots of concentration on their face to get through this first experience and gain some mileage as they develop. Young team. Take a look at some of the elements. Here's a look at the twizzles. I'm sorry, pardon me, this is the compulsory portion of the dance. Just getting used to skating with one another, knowing where each other is at all times. Of course, in the hold position, that's not a problem. It's when they separate into the twizzles or the step sequences. Here's a look. That'll jump right into the twizzle. Pretty good synchronization. They do have a level 3 on the first side, level 2 on the back. As they gain more experience and strength, they'll be a little faster through that series. And the entrance into the straight line lift, that's in at level 3. All the elements have just a small minus GOE for quality. That's expected as you're just starting out at the Junior Grand Prix and gaining some confidence. Just a matter of time for everyone. Lots of practice. Make it second nature.
The scores, please. Corinna Huber and Patrick Huber from Austria have earned a total
and the scores for Corinna
score
and Patrick,
31.76
for the rhythm dance.
Which brings
they're currently
them
in second
in the
place.
Second place. On the ice, representing China, CZ Shen and Jiangjing Qing.
CZ and Jiangjing, 16 years old, both born in Harbin. This is their first Junior Grand Prix season together. Coached by Zhang Chen Zheng, choreographed by Jamie White.
Qizhi Shen and Jiangjing Qing.
And let's take a look at some of the elements. To look at the twizzles. Notice that Jiang Ying just got on his toe picks a lot there. You can see the scratches. He's rocking back and forth. But did manage to get a level 4 out of both sides of that with quite a large minus GOE for quality. There's some challenges with the quality of that. Look at the midline steps. Nice synchronization here. Good distance between the skaters. Level 1 on the midline steps. Here's a look at a quick pickup. Look a little wild, but he managed to control that very nicely. Level 4. Of course, the Chinese Federation, very solid in pair skating and singles, and the ladies in the dance coming along, getting more people involved. They are the host of the Olympic Games coming up in 2022. Imagine some big programs to develop their young skaters. Field as large a team as they possibly can for our home games.
Scores, please.
And let's take a look at the scores.
Qiji Shen and Jiang Jingqing from China have
and the rhythm dance score 39.36. They're currently in the first place.
That brings them currently into the first place. On the ice, representing Russia, Sofia Shevchenko and Igor Eremenko.
Sofia 16, Igor 21. She was born in Moscow. He and Ostrava Don, third junior Grand Prix season. They're coached by Irina Zhuk and Alexander Zvinin, and choreographed by Elena Samarskaya. Skating the rhythm dance to the tango.
Thank you.
Sofia Shevchenko and Igor Ermenko.
Well, both Sofia and Igor have such remarkable basic skating skills. Forget about dancing together at this moment. Just as individuals, the strength of their deep edges and control, they almost make it look like they're dancing on the floor as opposed to the ice, being, you know, obviously slipperier and more difficult to keep themselves balanced. They didn't lose their balance anywhere. Just beautifully done. Take a look at some of the circular steps portion of the no touch, with the depth of the edges and how they keep their speed and flow across the ice, making it look effortless, as if they're almost motorized, not pushing too hard to accelerate. Beautiful flow. Detail to the music, the arms, the feet, the heads, everything beautifully done. Here's the Twizzles, the interesting entrance to the Twizzles. You watch at the end here, very unique exit. This is the second set. They're both at level 4 with a GOE quality of 1.77. Watch here. She goes into a back spin right away. Yeah, nicely done. Very innovative. And the straight line lift. Difficult position for the man, change of position for the lady. Now with that new range of plus 5, minus 5, we haven't seen in the juniors any plus GOEs of 3 or above. This team here has a couple in the 2s, so obviously the quality well recognized.
Sofia Shevchenko and Igor Ermenko.
Let's take a look at the score. Sofia and Igor, 64.26, nod of approval from both coach and skaters, and they're currently in first place. Very nicely done indeed.
The following competitors may now take the ice for a 5-minute warm-up. From Russia, Eva Kutz and Dmitry Mikhailov. From Italy, Sara Campanini and Francesca Riva.
And a look at the current
from
standings
Canada,
after the first group.
Marjorie LaJoy and Zachary Lega. And from Australia, Matilda Friend and William Badoui.
Well, just to give you a little bit of an idea of the detail by which the judges GOEs, I'm just going to, and in the levels of difficulty, I'm going to just read you something that is due to a change of pose and lifting part. It moves through at least three rotations. So, and that's only one little portion of many details in which the technical panel has to assess the element for levels of difficulty. And of course, it's the same thing for the judges, have many criteria to know at the top of their head to be able to assess the quality. So it's not easy. The judges are extremely well-trained, technical panel as well. They go through rigorous exams and many hours of practice. So they recognize it just naturally. They can see it instinctively almost. The sport's not any longer sort of, it does have an overall impression, one little aspect of it, but it's very specific to the detail by which every skater performs every element. Now that's as much detail as I'm going to get into, because I will confuse everyone, including myself, especially with dance. There's so many details to follow. But the addition of the plus 5, minus 5 seems to be well received by all the skaters, coaches, and the officials. So a very positive move by the ISU this year. It'll take a while to really sort of embed itself naturally, but the training has already happened this year for all the judges. and they seem to enjoy that wider range. And a look at the start order for Group 2, currently on the ice, finishing up their warm-up. And here's a look at the events that are coming up. Of course, we're in Linz, Austria this week. We move to Kaunas, Lithuania next week. Richmond, Canada, my hometown just right outside of Vancouver. Ostrava, Czech Republic, Ljubljana, Slovenia, Yerevan in Armenia. And we go back to Vancouver for the Senior and Junior Grand Prix Final. That'll be December 6th to 9th. Don't miss that. That will be an exciting event.
Couples, there is one more minute left in this warm-up.
Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and on Twitter. Make sure you sign up on YouTube to get your alerts as to when we post videos and when we go live with streaming.
This warm-up has ended. Please clear the ice. On the ice, representing Russia, Eva Kutz and Dmitry Mikhailov.
Eva is 17, born in St. Petersburg. Dmitry, 20, born in Moscow. This is their second Junior Grand Prix season. They're coached by Katerina Rubleva. Skating the rhythm dance to tango. Thank you.
Eva Kutz and Dmitry Mikhailov.
Well, both Eva and Dmitry, of course, also have extreme individual skating skills, which gives them stability and confidence. So important to train those skating skills as individuals before you start to match the teams up. Here's a look at their lift. Difficult entry on this curve lift. Change of position. He's in a difficult position. Spread eagle. Nicely done. It's a level four, the plus GOE. Here's a look at the midline step sequence. Good unison, nice and close, good deep edges. Really beautifully executed. That's a midline step, level three. Also has, 1.8. Plus GOE, it's good. Remember, it's a 5-point scale. 4 plus and 5 for minus. There's the twizzles. Nicely done. Level 3 in the first twizzle, level 4 in the second. Connection between the two will improve as time goes on, as they grow together.
The scores, please.
Let's take a look at the scores.
Eva Kutz and Dmitry Mikhailov.
Eva and Dmitry in the rhythm dance of a 58.63. That currently moves them into second place.
And this currently brings them into the second place. On the ice, representing Italy, Sara Campanini and Francesco Riva.
Sara, 15, born in Milan. Francesco, 18, born also in Milan. This is their first Junior Grand Prix season. They are coached and choreographed by Matteo Zani. Thank you.
Sara Campanini and Francesco Riva.
Well, nice job by Sarah and Francesco. They certainly on the key points in their compulsory part of the dance had great success. Have seven yeses and one no for the detailed steps that judges are looking for. That's very strong. Let's take a look at some of the elements here. Here's the midline step sequence. Carry good speed across the ice. This is a level 3. Pretty healthy plus Dewey, so judges like the quality of the step sequence. And a look at the entrance into the twizzles. Twizzles were both sides were level 4. Pretty good synchronization there. Done. Here's the compulsory portion part of the dance. They're a little far away, where their hips are quite far away. Separation there, you can see the real top teams are a lot tighter and closer together on that compulsory portion. But certainly, this is a work in progress. I'm sure they're strong, pretty strong skaters. This will come in time. There's nice, unexpected pickup on the lift. Rotational lift, which is a level 4 with a plus GOE. Overall, very nicely done.
The scores, please. Sara Campanini and Francesco Riva have
Sara and Francesco 54.09. They seem to be very happy with that.
This
it was a good program.
Into the third place.
And they're currently sitting in third place.
On the ice, representing Canada, Marjorie Lajoie and Zachary Lega.
Marjorie, 17, born in Boucherville, Quebec. Zachary, 19, born in Greenfield Park, Quebec. This is their fourth Junior Grand Prix season. They're coached by Marie-France Debray, Patrice Lauzon, Roman Hagenauer.
Marjorie LaJoy and Zachary Lega.
Well, another demonstration of a team that has very good individual skating skills, very strong. Take a look here at the twizzles right off the top. Perfectly timed to the music, synchronized and close. Level 3 and a level 4, but a very high GOE of over 2. Some of the midline step sequence, nice and close, good speed and flow. This is what they've really improved since last year. Of course, they were Junior Grand Prix finalists last year. But their speed and ice coverage definitely improved, getting stronger every year. It's a rotational lift, unexpected pickup, good speed across the ice. Just a little bit late on the ending of the music. Just fight that little pose a bit, but beautifully done. Should see a good score here.
The scores, please. Marjorie LaJoy and Zachary Lega have earned in the rhythm dance
63.95 for the rhythm dance.
This brings them currently into score, the second place.
Puts them currently into second place.
On the ice, representing Australia, Matilda Friend and William Barui.
Matilda 19, William 20, both born in Sydney. They're coached by Monica McDonald.
Matilda Friend and William Badoui.
Well, Matilda and William both have very strong skating skills. They pick up speed very easily, powerful on the ice, good ice coverage. Wow, that was nicely done. Indeed, let's take a look at some of the elements are coached by Monica McDonald and John Dunn there. You see in the picture. First element, midline steps. Currently in at level one. Separation there. Here's a look at the straight line lift to level three. The small positive GOE. A difficult entrance into the twizzles there. Risky with that pull through. Level three at the first side, level four on the second. And just a small minus for the quality for the GOE. Strong skaters, a little bit more time, a little bit more mileage.
The scores, please.
Take a look at the scores for the rhythm dance.
Matilda
and William, 45.05, a nod of approval by both coach and skaters. And that currently puts them into fifth place. And take a look at the standings after the first two groups. Sophia and Igor, 64.26. Marjorie and Zachary, 63.95. Nice and close there. Eva and Dimitri, 58.63. Your top three. And a look at the rest of the field. Well, we'll take a short break for the ice to be resurfaced. You're watching live coverage of the ICU Junior Grand Prix 2018 from Linz, Austria. I'm your host, Ted Barton. We'll be right back after the ice resurfacing.
The few ones, and I'll never lose. have to be afraid of what you are. There's an answer if you reach into your soul, and the sorrow that you know will melt away. The strength to carry on, and you cast your fears aside, and you know you can't survive. So when you feel like hope is gone, look inside you and be strong, and you'll finally see the truth that a hero lies in you.
כמו מאומה לא קרה
Back everyone to Linz, Austria, week two of the ISU Junior Grand Prix 2018. I'm your host, Ted Barton. Beautiful looking downtown. What a charming little city this is. We love coming here. I'm gonna look outside the building. Welcome back inside the arena. I'm your host, Ted Barton. You're watching live coverage of the ISU Junior Grand Prix. We welcome viewers from around the world who joined us to watch some of the extraordinary young people passionately deliver the sport of beauty. Make sure you can follow us. You follow us on social media, for Facebook and Instagram, Twitter, and of course YouTube.
5 minute warm up.
Group three, final
from
group
France,
in the ice dance. Rhythm dance on the ice for the warm up.
From Germany, Charisse Mathé and Maximilian Pfisterer.
And here's a look at the current standings after the
from
first
Canada,
two groups.
Natalie D'Alessandro and Bruce Waddell. From the United States of America, Jocelyn Haynes and James Costa. And also from the United States of America, Sophia Elder and Christopher Elder.
Well, we'd love to hear from the viewers from around the world and where you're watching from and what device you're watching on. You can email me directly at jgpbarton@gmail.com. jgpbarton, B-A-R-T-O-N, at gmail.com. Let us know where you're watching from, what devices you're watching. If you watched last week in Bratislava, your thoughts on any of the skaters, good comments, I'll pass them on to the viewers. Once Once again, it's jgpbarton, B-A-R-T-O-N, at gmail.com. And a look at the start order for the third group on the ice, just finishing up the warm-up. Thank you for that email, Shari, from Lockport, New York, cheering on the American dance team. And remember to follow us on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and Twitter. Another greeting from Boston. Thank you for sending that email. And Yavera from Chile. Man from Chile in South America, watching for about 2 years Junior Grand Prix. You're very welcome for the streaming. We love getting the sport exposed around the world.
Couples, this warm-up has ended. Please clear the ice. On the ice, representing France, Lou Thurin and Noé Perron.
Lou is 16, born in Belfort. Noah is 18 years old, coached and choreographed by Karen Arabe-Nars.
Que me servent mes épargnes? Je vais là où je front et le savon à la main. Au suivant, au suivant. J'avais juste 20 ans et nous étions 120 à être le suivant de celui qu'on suivait. Au suivant, au suivant. J'avais juste 20 ans et je me déniaisais au bordel ambulant d'une armée en campagne.
Lutheran, ein neuer Perron.
Take a look at some of the elements. Good unison, nice and close, that's good. Maybe a little bit more flow and speed throughout the steps. It'll come with years of practice. Here's a look at the entrance into the twizzles. She unfortunately did not get the blade, so they'll lose that. Second set, the twizzles are in at level 3 and level 4, minus GOE for quality. And here's an entrance to the stationary lift.
It's 45.25
for the rhythm dance, and that puts them currently into fifth place. There's a look at your top five so far. The competition for more teams to come.
On the ice, representing Germany, Charisse Mathé and Maximilian Pfisterer.
Charisse, 17, born in Berlin. Maximilian, 21, born in Munich. This is their second Junior Grand Prix season. Coached by René Sachsler-Los. Stefano Crusso and Barbara Fusopoli are the choreographers. Skating to a flamingo, Argentine.
Paris Mathé and Maximilian Pfisterer.
Well, Charisse and Maximilian had a really strong start. We'll take a look at what happened on that fall in the Twizzles. But the start of that was so good. Here's the entrance of the Twizzles. Good synchronization, good speed, good position. Change directions. Everything's looking good there. Oh, just caught the back of her heel. I was so surprised. I looked down for a second. I saw him down. I didn't know why did he fall, but he just caught her heel. Very unfortunate. There's a look at the stationary lift. The end of the program. It's a level 3, small plus GOE. And some of the diagonal steps a little far apart at the top of that step sequence. Sometimes when there's an unexpected mistake, it unnerves you a little bit, pulls you back. Begin to protect and not push out.
The scores, please.
Scores for Charisse and Maximilian for the rhythm dance, 45.43. That currently puts them into fifth place. Here's a look at the top five so far. Three teams yet to skate.
On the ice, representing Canada, Natalie D'Alessandro and Bruce Waddell.
Natalie, 14 years old, born in Toronto. Bruce, 16, also born in Toronto. This is their first Junior Grand Prix season together. They're coached by Andrew Hallam and Siobhan Karam, choreographed by Mary-France Debray, Roman Hagenauer.
Natalie D'Alessandro and Bruce Waddell.
Well, a nice clean skate here this afternoon by Natalie and Bruce. Elements. And set up for the twizzles, steps coming in, good speed across the ice, good synchronization, nice extensions, step into the other direction. Bruce almost stops on that one. Steps nice and close, clear movements with the music, good posture, really nicely done, nice and tidy step sequence. It is currently in the system at midline step number level two. with a nice positive GOE. Look into the entrance, into the rotational lift. There's the pickup. But it is only in at a level one.
Please.
Still a nice job. Should see a pretty Natalie decent Del score Sango here.
And Bruce Waddell
for Natalie and Bruce, 50.45 for the rhythm dance. And that puts them currently into
that
fifth place.
That brings them currently into the fifth place. On the ice, representing the United States of America, Jocelyn Haynes and James Kosuta.
Jocelyn 16, born in China. James is 20, born in Buffalo, New York. This is their first Junior Grand Prix season.
Jocelyn Haynes and
look at some of the elements for Jocelyn and James. Inline steps. Interesting, right here. Very close. Nice done. Diagonal steps. They're currently in at level one. And the twizzles are in first side here at a level three. Second set at level two's had some challenges there. Loss of balance by both. Rotational lift, level four.
Scores, please. Jocelyn Haynes and James
Kosova. Scores for Jocelyn and James, 46.83
in the rhythm dance. That brings them
currently into sixth place.
On the ice, representing the United States of America, Sophia Elder and Christopher Elder.
Sophia from Louisville, Christopher also from Louisville. This is their second Junior Grand Prix season. Thank you.
Sophia Elder and Christopher Elder.
Pretty solid skate for Sophia. He had Christopher. All the elements were positive, no negative GOEs at this point anyways. And here's a look at the twizzles. Nice unison. Good ice coverage, the steps in between. Well, that was nice. The third set done as well. The level three on both sides of the twizzles. Nice, healthy, positive GOE for the quality. Here's a look at some of the midline steps, currently in at level two. There are four levels of difficulty. It is very hard to get a level four in the steps. Some of the teams, the seniors, do that. Haven't really seen that in a junior competition yet. And here's a look at the rotational lift in at level four. Baby, I just know you can't start a fire. You can't start a fire without a spark. This comes for higher. Even if we're just dancing. You sit around getting older. There's a joke, it's a wine. The scores, please. And the rhythm dance scores Sophia for Sophia
Elder
and Christopher, from the United States.
49.58
points. That, and that currently them puts them into sixth place.
This concludes the rhythm dance. There will be a
and
break
here's
now,
a look at the final standings after the rhythm dance. Sophia and Igor of Russia, 64.26. Marjorie and Zachary of Canada, 63.95. And Neva and Dimitri of Russia, 58.63. Your top three. And a look at the rest of the field. And a look at the rest of the schedule for today. The men's short program takes to the ice pretty soon here at 16:30 local time here in Linz. And tomorrow's schedule, we begin with a pair of short program at 11 o'clock in the morning. And then the ladies short at 13:30. The men's free program will take to the ice tomorrow night at 18:45. And Saturday's schedule, the free dance will happen at 10:30 in the morning. Pairs free follows that at 1300 hours, and then the ladies free program, that'll be exciting at 1545 Saturday afternoon here from Linz. And a look at our remaining schedule. Of course, we'll finish this week out on Saturday here in Linz, and we'll move to Kaunas in Lithuania, then to Richmond, Canada, suburb of Vancouver in Canada, Ostrava, Czech Republic, onto Ljubljana, Slovenia. Yerevan in Armenia will be our last junior Grand Prix, and of course we'll move to Vancouver, Canada for the Grand Prix Junior and Senior Final, December 6th to 9th. Thank you everyone for watching. Make sure you join us for the men's short program coming up soon.